Hello, listeners. And hello, the manufacturers of the Zoom H4N handy audio recorder.
You fucking cunts.
To whom two bars apparently means it's gonna die in half an hour and not tell you.
Yeah, it didn't even beep. It didn't do a goddamn thing. This is the second time we've done this. I'm playing through fucking Final Fight as Hagar, and boy, am I happy to be doing this.
Yeah, we already explained this fully and in quite interesting detail. We had some good banter going. It was good. I was saying that Hagar's, like, leaping attack looks a bit sexually aggressive.
Gay jokes, penis references, it was all there.
To say nothing of that pile driver he just did.
I've been German suplexed, it hurts.
But now, thanks to the manufacturers of the H4N Zoom handy audio recorder, you're not gonna hear all of that gold.
You're gonna hear fucking silent, resentful button clicks as I mash my way through this whole fucking game again.
Look at these guys, they're all the same guy. Laugh! How funny is that?
Vests, pectoral muscles.
And we didn't even see the intro sequence, did we?
I don't fucking care. Basically, someone abducted Jesse Ventura's daughter, and now we have to go fucking pile drive our way back to familial, you know, togetherness.
See, that's what I don't get. I mean, surely you kidnap someone so you can have some leverage over them.
No, Mad Gear. This is that kind of, like...
I mean, if Hagar's just closing in on them, beating up all their men, and stabbing them with knives, why don't they just threaten to kill Jessica unless he stops?
They don't understand crime. This is that kind of, like, 80s, early 90s kind of thing where, like, criminals did crime for the fun of it. Like, they considered themselves criminals. They weren't doing it for, like, money or gain or anything. It's just like, I like crime!
The punks who threaten Arnie at the start of Terminator. Those sorts of guys.
Yeah, like that, but, like, organized somehow and more of them.
Just for the love of crime.
For the love of crime. They're art. It's performance art, basically.
And wearing headbands.
Stop blocking.
And all wearing shirts that absolutely do nothing to cover the pectoral muscles.
Well, you don't, you know... You don't cover that. That's half the fun of pectoral muscles. That's dude cleavage, man. You don't put that shit away.
Okay.
Sweet, delicious, pulsating man gams.
I don't think you can speak for everyone.
Pecs are good. Do a lot of push-ups. Good for you.
I do find it suspicious that Hagar's main punch seems to go straight for the dick.
It's effective, man. Like, this is street fighting. This isn't your, like, sort of, you know... in the octagon kind of, you know, respectful competition thing. There's eye gouging, you stabbing people. This isn't about fun, this is about hurting.
And punching transsexuals.
Yeah, okay, here's one for you, internet. What's worse, beating up a woman or beating up someone transgender? Because originally Poison was a woman, and then they didn't like the idea of hitting a woman, so they made her transgender. So, you know, feel free to argue that one amongst yourselves. I'm sure we'll reach a conclusion in the comments.
Because interestingly, they did the reverse with Birdo in Super Mario 2. The original manual said he was a boy who pretended to be a girl.
Yeah.
But they thought that was distasteful for the kiddie winks.
Oh, for fuck's sake. You know what irritates me about that is, understanding, like, the fucking rainbow of gender identity only necessitates the existence of, like, four or more, like, new stereotypes. It's really, that's just it. It's like, oh, there's a dude that wears women's clothing. There's a gay dude that wears women's clothing. There's a straight dude that wears women's clothing. That's a woman who, you know, wants to be a man. That's a man who wants to be a woman. It's, like, it's literally, like, five extra things you have to remember, and you're good.
I think you're waffling.
Well, yeah, all the fucking good stuff's gone, Yahtzee. Prepare for waffling.
I know. It was pretty good. I was impressed at us.
Gender and shit. It's not fucking hard.
But now we're running on angry fumes.
There's Andre the Giant. I want Yahtzee to dress up like Andor, actually. If you frizzled his hair and put him in, like, some leopard print...
Yeah, we had a whole routine about that, didn't we?
I had a callback later. It was so good.
I was saying I only cosplay as people who you wouldn't look twice at on the bus. And that's why I have a costume.
To be perfectly honest, I wouldn't want to be caught looking at you on the bus dressed like that.
And that's why I cosplay as James Sunderland from Silent Hill 2. I have the jacket on my coat rack.
Like, if you saw someone dressed as Andor on the bus, would you really want to look at him?
Not
like,
Andor, Andore.
Andore!
Andore, final fight too.
Final fight. American muscle justice, pile driver. To be fair, pile drivers solve problems.
Of course, the actual Andre the Giant was a notoriously physically frail man.
That gigantism is not healthy, man. Yeah. Like, there's only a few people who manage to get away with being that big. Apparently Yao Ming is, like, remarkable because his heart isn't insanely stressed and his knees work.
The larger than average size usually leads to a shorter than average life, so,
Bread, I just headbutt a dude called Bread.
I'll probably die before you do.
I don't think it's the same if you're, like, an inch or so taller.
I'm 6'5".
That's not like Andre. Andre was 7.
Well, there is that, I suppose.
And, you know, also had gigantism. And
I am broad-shouldered.
Yeah. That'll change as you get older. You'll wither into the typical tall British pudgy stick insect.
Tall British pudgy stick insect?
Yeah, you know, kind of like, imagine sort of a kind of fucking hell.
Man, that just took you apart.
Yeah, Capcom was kind of vicious in the old days for sort of just attacks that get rid of all your health. Like, if you play the original Street Fighter, well, not the original Street Fighter, but if you play Street Fighter 2, characters like E Honda have a throw where they pick you up and squeeze you, and they will literally take away 3/4 of your health bar in one fucking move.
It's funny how no one talks about Street Fighter 1 anymore.
Fucking awful. Was that the one that was terrible?
Was that the one that was more of a brawler?
No, it was a one-on-one fighting game before anyone had really worked out how those are supposed to work.
Those guys look so pensive when they're sitting waiting for you. It's like, okay, we've got to get through this.
Here he comes.
And you can do this, Axel or yeah. Jay.
Here comes, come on, Ultra Freddy Mercury.
You can do this barrel. Oh, that was just a barrel.
It was just a barrel.
Why has the barrel got a health bar? That seems redundant.
Don't be, you know, don't oppress it just because it's a non-sentient object. It gets a fucking health bar.
But it only takes one hit. That is my point. That is why it does not need a health bar.
Pile driver a motherfucker into another motherfucker. Is it recording?
Yes, we're still recording.
We're checking the fucking record now, are we?
Just checking.
Because I'm not doing this again today. I'm going home and just, I don't know, screaming.
I don't think anyone would blame you. I'm remembering at this point I said a very funny thing about how there must be some kind of knife Easter Bunny going around Final Fight.
Yeah,
it explains how you get out of that game over screen as well.
This is getting to that thing where it's like, this is kind of exactly sexual experiences with me back when I was drinking. Is you'd take me home and I'd be fucking wankered, and it would be like trying to hump a lump of warm Vaseline, and it would be embarrassing and terrible. And then the next day it'd be like, no, okay, there's good coming. So, like, then you'd have to do, like, a better version. And this is kind of the reverse of that. We did the better version, and now it's just the shithouse version, and we're sorry.
That's going to be your autobiography. A warm lump of Vaseline.
Warm lump.
The Gabriel Morton
story.
Yeah,
like trying to fuck a warm lump of Vaseline. Just a little nub. It's kind of crested, a bit like meringue, but it's not really a solid.
Wait, are you the giver or the receiver in this analogy?
The giver.
Okay.
I'm the warm lump of Vaseline. I'm not going to describe this more than I have. I think it's done.
So it's the old shoving a marshmallow into a letterbox analogy.
Yeah.
I see.
Well, see, processing booze takes testosterone, and that's why when you get fucking hammered, all your testosterone's gone on that, and you have nothing for penis.
I don't think pipes work if they're that square. I think that you'll get some clogs. We didn't have that joke in the last record. See? This is still good.
Look at Sodom. You made an appearance in Street Fighter Alpha.
You missed.
Sodom's a bit fucking irritating because he's got this wake-up attack, which is, yeah, kind of. I swear the timing fucking changes on it too. Pile drivers will solve this problem.
Hey, everyone in the audience, look 10 feet to your left. There is another of you there. It must be some kind of singularity.
I think this is the city of the clones from like a distant future from our own.
Knife Easter Bunny gets you out of a jam again. But it seems the Knife Easter Bunny has a thing going with Sodom as well.
Yeah. He's not a bunny, he's a jackrabbit.
I think he's just an agent of chaos. He likes to bring knives wherever he can.
Knives, they're fun for kids, give them to them, it'll be fine.
Good guys, bad guys, he'll give anyone a knife.
Hey, you look like you need a knife. Thanks, Knife Easter Bunny.
Sodom must have had a very strict religious upbringing to have that name. Ah, yes, this bit I know.
Yep, they gotta all beat the shit out of the car.
You have to break Japan the car.
I have a friend who's, like a mechanic, basically, like, been one of those people who always has bits of car in his yard that he's working on building and repairing and what have you. And I actually, like, I was like, there's this wreck over there. He's like, can I punch that car? And he's like, yeah, sure. It's actually really hard.
Hey, your pipe's sort of floating a foot off the ground there.
Yeah.
Is someone going to draw attention to that?
It'll do that. No, the guy that comes in now won't even notice. He's too busy worrying about his Japanmobile.
I don't know. I think he might be surprised at the pipe there.
Oh my god, physics isn't working.
He didn't look like the guy who owned that car, I gotta say.
I mean, yeah, he looked like the guy who stole the car.
Yeah, it didn't seem like he'd be that attached.
This is
what I didn't like about your side on Brawler. It's difficult to tell which vertical plane the characters are on. And there's a lot of punching slightly to the left and slightly to the right of dudes.
Yeah, that happens, but the spinning lariat takes care of that, but it uses a little bit of health.
See, I don't really like fighting games, and we picked it for Let's Drown Out because Gabriel playing fighting games always kind of bores me.
Well, okay. It's a bit like golf in that if you don't appreciate the subtlety of it, it does just look fucking boring. Like tennis. I don't appreciate tennis, so it looks fucking boring, so I don't watch it.
It's like a production line. Molest a man with your molest attack.
Knuckle molest.
Then molest the same man with the same molest attack.
Imagine, like, seriously, Yahtzee, you could totally pull that costume off. I just gotta frizz your hair up, put on some, like, Dayglo leopard print, wrap a chain around you.
You keep telling me I could pass off costumes.
Yeah, you could. You should do more.
And I refuse to.
I mean, honestly, you should show up to, like, next Supernova dress like that, and the only word you say to people is pile driver.
Maybe I'll do General Zod.
Yeah, I don't think you could do a Zod.
I got the young Terrence Stamp beard.
If you think so.
Man, a lot of exciting things must happen in this bar if those
well,
guys...
Well, there's a child in the bar, so that... Right there, that's a kid.
Yeah.
Hey kid, I'm the mayor, okay? Get the fuck back home.
I think it might
stay in school.
I think it might just be a short lesbian woman.
yeah, kinda like Ellen lesbian.
Yeah, that's the vibe I'm getting.
You know what I like? The gays have categories of gays, which is something straight people really need to have. Like, you know how there's like bears and twinks and shit like this? Like, and what that means is there's more ways for people to be attractive.
Well, straights have categories as well.
Yeah, but not to, like, the simple fucking degree that the gay community seems to have done with. Like, a twink's a hideous bear, and a bear's a hideous twink. But, because they're not those things. You're going, you know, to judge a fucking bear by twink standards is just ridiculous. You're just being silly.
Thinking that the knife bunny's been really generous to the lesbian lady.
Well, you know, I'm an advocate of small women carrying knives to defend themselves, provided they know how to use them. I recommend that. I used to teach women self-defense, and honestly, unless you're willing to really dedicate yourself to... And I mean, you know, you can't learn this shit in an hour class, like...
Wouldn't that just lead to lots of small women stabbing people?
Well, if someone gets in my face three fucking times, like, you know, they get a few warnings until I'm about to fucking hit them. But well, I can do that because I'm big. Well, a woman doesn't have that option.
Well, not everyone has your discipline.
Yeah, but I mean,
what if you give a knife to a woman who is a psychotic?
Well, I mean, trust me, psycho women are going to get a hold of a pointy thing regardless of whether you give it to them or not. But ultimately, the thing is, you can run away from a knife. So if you're getting near enough to get stabbed, you should probably just not be that close to the person waving a knife at you and telling you to fuck off.
Yeah, alright.
I mean, that, you know...
That's self-defense tips from the big lump of cookie dough over here.
Hey, fuck you. I'm not cookie dough.
Yes, you are. We went over this.
I maintain you don't know what muscle is if you think that I'm cookie dough.
Listeners, Gabe gets really defensive when I describe him as doughy, but he totally is.
I am not doughy.
He's so doughy.
He's like a big
wobbling lump of white blancmange.
He's just fucking jealous.
Jealous?
I'm actually showing fucking
jealous?
You know, actually
you
showing
see-
benefit for my fucking, you know, my work that I've been doing.
Have you seen this shit? Anyway, we had a heated argument in the first record when we were talking about the game of the year, which was one of our topics.
And Yahtzee's stupid shitty choice.
Fuck you! Because of course my choice of game of the year, and I actually was able to come up with one quickly, unlike Gabe, who ummed and erred for like 5 minutes.
Well, I have reasons that I ummed and erred.
Doing that thing he does.
I find game of the year a flawed concept to begin with.
Doing that thing he does where he just sort of meanders around the philosophy of the question without answering the fucking question.
The philosophy is important to the answering of the question.
But my point is, my game of the year the game of the year that I most enjoyed and was most thinking of still at the end of the year was Bioshock Infinite. Because of its creative design and interesting atmosphere and central story. And
that was, like Bioshock, the original one, remember that?
Well, completely unlike Bioshock, and yet somehow with the same, like, general themes.
The same fucking combat system, the vigors that are just completely thematically unrelated to the actual location or style.
Well, I'm kind of with you on that, but But how can you say the combat was no different when there was the whole rail traveling thing?
Oh, you mean those things you jump on to get from place to place and then land in a box that you had to shoot things?
I used it all the time to get an advantage in combat.
It was never helpful.
You were playing it wrong. You had to use the rail system.
You're playing it wrong. I just picked up that guy's gum and it was worth points. That's fucking gross, Hagar. That's not okay.
Maybe that was his lover.
I mean, seriously, though, the Vigors was fucking turned. Insulting and stupid. Because this is... Colombia is a place where interracial marriage is an unacceptable level of genetic alteration. And you're supposed to expect me to believe they're okay with, like, injecting yourself with something that lets you shoot crows.
Well, that's...
Bullshit. Well, that's... Lazy.
Well, that's dwelling on the peripheries.
It's not. And the plot is
the
something...
The center of Bioshock Infinite is a story about characters and about the redemption of the main character in particular. And that's what I liked about it.
Look, the story itself is not that bad. The little multi-dimensional twist at the end is really something that's only going to be remarkable to, like, millennials who've never read any sci-fi.
Well, it's good that it wasn't the whole thing then, isn't it?
No. The ooh-la-di-da about the fucking plot was all about the multiple dimensions, which also reduced the original... fucking Bioshock to feeling like a side quest.
Well, that's what I liked. It made me sort of look back over all of Ken Levine's body of work and think, could, with the perspective of Bioshock Infinite, could we consider Bioshock and System Shock 2 and Bioshock Infinite as a sort of unconventional trilogy, exploring, like, from the central starting point of a man about which we know nothing arriving in a corrupted utopia. But at the end of that, actually deconstructing that, as you'd expect from a trilogy.
But it would have... I don't know. See, to me, it would have worked better without having to relate itself back to Rapture at all.
I think it worked. I still haven't played the Burial of Sea DLC, and I've been meaning to get around
to it. And as a linear shooter, the thing is, the linear shooter worked in Rapture because Rapture was a hostile environment.
Well, yeah,
Rapture was out to get you.
Yeah. So was Columbia.
No, but there were regular people that you could have conversations with that were meaningless. And, like, these terrible kind of attempts almost at side quests.
How can you say Columbia was not out to get you?
Well, not at...
You were, like, public enemy number one.
Well, yeah, but there was also a rebellion group that was kind of sort of on your side.
Yeah,
like, it would
and,
have
then
worked...
they, and then they were out to get you.
Yeah, which was kind
well.
Of like the lazy double cross. And it would have worked better as an adventure with Metroidvania style ways
of
getting around.
I don't think it was a lazy double cross. It was actually interesting how they did that.
Because now you're in another dimension.
Because what they did was you have to travel to another universe
to get out of the way of a rock.
Basically just for convenience's sake.
Which
and
was
the
fucking retarded.
But that's the point. It was convenient, and then it bites you in the arse because then the resistance turns against you because you're supposed to be the dead martyr in that universe.
Yeah, I found the dimension jumping to get rid of basic fucking obstructions dumb.
But that was the point.
No, it really it just that it, and like the punishment for it was stupid. Like again,
I don't
whole,
see
like,
how you can say it didn't work as a linear narrative. It's basically an odyssey. It's about the journey of these characters take.
It's not that the narrative was a problem. When you put a narrative into an area that feels like it shouldn't be, that's when it becomes a problem. It's like the way people keep putting linear narratives into sandbox games and wondering why the narrative fucking
sucks.
Well,
it's a good thing this wasn't a sandbox game then, isn't
it?
This
one actually friggin' should have been.
No, it was a shooter. No, I don't think it should have been.
It would have been more interesting that way.
But then it couldn't have had the narrative it had, which was its strong point.
No, it could have had the narrative. It was not like sandbox. Not like Full Tilt Sandbox. I'm not talking about...
Somewhere like Metroidvania.
Yeah,
like
where it's... more open than it was.
I still don't agree because at its heart it's an odyssey. And you can't just go wherever you want.
Metroid's not a fucking odyssey?
Well, not really. Because
I don't know,
in an
Metroid
odyssey...
Metroid felt odyssey-ish.
In an odyssey, you can't go to any point in the odyssey whenever you like. An odyssey is like a journey. It's a transformation from point to point.
Well, yeah, but the retreads in those things... kind of like the actual optional elements. Like, you can kind of skip them if you want, but you get benefits for going back. It still has a very definite forward progression.
Yeah.
Yeah, which I think would have been better suited for this. Instead, we get this thing where it's like, oh, I've got a key to a safe now, and I go back, like, you know, two little bits to where the safe was, and now I can open the safe. Yeah, that's nice.
I think you're talking out of your bum, but now that we...
No, I'm not saying it's a horrible game. Game of the year...
Yes.
No.
Well, what would you call Game of the Year?
Well,
Gabriel?
I think Game of the Year is a flawed concept to begin with.
There you go again!
Yeah, because it's part of my fucking answer. Fuck you. This isn't like trial. You're not allowed to go yes or no.
Don't. This is not a Newsnight interview. You are not Michael Howard. Just.
I don't know who that is. That's a British reference.
Alright, well, just say the name of a game that was your favorite game this year.
I'd go. Like, there's basically three that's.
No, stop, stop, stop. I'm gonna have to stop you there. Say the next thing that comes out of your mouth is the name of a game. Go. That was not the name of a game. That was an inward sigh. Say the name of a game.
Wasn't something that came out of my mouth. It went in, you motherfucker.
You're analyzing again. Say the name of a... Shut up. Name of game now.
Tomb Raider.
Okay. Why the fuck did you pick Tomb Raider? It's shit.
Yeah, it's in no way shittier than fucking... It was actually interesting.
All right, that was one of my contenders.
Yeah,
for games of the year, it was actually kind of interesting,
and probably because the thing is, for me, Game of the Year is like Oscar movie in that it is, I think, an inherently flawed concept, and it's becoming a genre in and of its own. Game of the Year is a genre. Whether that's the game I played most in a year or actually found most fun is. Again, like, kind of debatable. It's like when the difference when you ask someone to name their favorite game or what they think the best game is, their favorite game will be quite unique to them. What they think the best game is will generally come a little bit closer. So I may not have found them to be the most fun games in terms of the concept of Game of the Year, though I'd definitely go something either Tomb Raider, Last of Us, or I've been enjoying the shit out of Max Payne 3. I don't know if that was this year or not, but...
See, that's an odd choice for me. I probably wouldn't even have put that in my top 10.
What, not Max... You didn't like Max Payne 3?
See, the very three you mentioned are the very three examples I would have taken this year for games taking themselves way too seriously.
Well, yeah, but that's Oscar movie. That's just Game of the Year game and a fucking... That's the problem with the concept.
I remember saying when Last of Us came out, it's Oscar bait. Yeah, it's the gaming equivalent of Oscar bait.
And I'd agree. Like, I really agree with that. But that's the problem with what we're talking about.
Last of Us was kind of a bugbear for me this year because everyone was all like, oh, it's the best game ever. Games are art. All of a sudden...
Yeah, but then you're judging the thing in the face of its fandom, and that's, like, I fall for that sometimes, too, and it's like how Doctor Who is made excruciating for me by the fucking fans, and it's just, I think it's a little unfair to the...
I think The Last of Us just didn't do it for me, it just didn't speak to me, and I think the problem with The Last of Us in particular is that I make this point in my column that I'm writing this week, but all opinion is subjective, as we know. But I think opinion on The Last of Us is more subjective than usual because it's a very, very
character-based
narrative. And if you don't get along with the character, if you don't really like identify with the characters, then the game lives or dies on that.
Well, what I find interesting about these three games, though, is they don't do anything revolutionary in terms of gameplay. They just finally do something gaming's been trying to do for ages without cocking up a major point of it. Because games like that have been tried a lot of times, but usually something will fuck up royal.
Well, there have been plenty of games that managed to have drama and emotion, like Shadow of the Colossus and Silent Hill 2, for example.
Those are very broad things to attempt. I'm talking about that kind of cinematic... cover shooter, dramatic sort of thing. Like, that style of game. Because they're all... It's like the equivalent of a paperback or a pulp novel. That's what those three games are. They're very similar, despite their differences. Because they look the same, tell the same kind of almost stylistic story, and have almost the same gameplay, with a few exceptions. Like, Tomb Raider had more platformy, explorey stuff to it.
Well, the objection I have for it... look at that little
dog. Why not Tomb Raider?
Look at that little dog. That dog is furious at you.
I mean, I'd have, if I was torn between Tomb Raider... I actually played Tomb Raider after I beat it. I did some exploring and looked around.
Well, I...
Because you can do that in that game.
The thing about Max Payne and Tomb Raider and...
Pills, booze!
And The Last of Us, to a lesser extent, is that the problem with those games is that the characters come across as whiny. And when I'm playing the kind of gameplay you get in Max Payne, i.e. jumping sideways through a window, shooting two pistols, and like awesomely getting 15 headshots before I hit the ground.
That's awesome.
What I do not want to hear at that point is a whining old scrote going, "Ugh, I'm fucking up and fucked up and about to fuck up and I'm continuing to fuck up." And I'm like, "Shut up, Max Payne, I'm having fun."
How he keeps calling himself a failure when he's basically Gun Christ.
That is I think that's an issue with games in general, because the thing about games is that you always have to be succeeding, don't you? That's gameplay.
Failure is hard to do in a game. That's why death, player character death is hard to do in a game.
I mean, I think Spec Ops: The Line did this really well, where violence had a consequence, but it made a point of the fact that you're forced into it.
See, I find his comedic self-loathing sort of because Max Payne's very hyper-stylized in that old gumshoe.
I get that, but I just found the character tiresome. I think they were overdoing it. And I think it might have been because Spec Ops: The Line was last year, but this year I was much more looking for games that didn't take themselves so seriously, and that's why games like Saints Row 4 and Metal Gear Rising Revengeance ended up in my top 5.
Saints Row games are good because not only are they parody themselves, and they also do it well.
I think Saints Row
actually fucking funny.
I think Saints Row 4 was the best possible way to close off the series because it is like a big parody, a big roast of itself.
Do you suppose they're actually going to close? Because here's the problem, and it's the wacky spiral, and all Dead Rising is in that bad at the moment, where you haven't made any actual gameplay changes, you're just getting successfully wackier with each iteration, and that has a fucking limit before it gets real tiresome.
I have...
Dead Rising 3, it has to do something, it has to change for the next one, because it can't
the wacky again. I have heard some worrying talk of making another Saints Row game, but I'm not sure how far along that is.
I mean, it's not to say that it couldn't be, you know, funny again if they get the sort of writers involved and add some more gameplay styles, but I mean, what can you do, really?
I'm not sure you could go any further with it.
I don't really think they can. I mean, I'm not going to sit here and completely 100% rule out the possibility, so I may be surprised, but I don't... Again, the wacky spiral is not a good thing to get caught in.
I was getting back to Damn Metal Gear battles. Rising Revengeance. I was a little hesitant.
I'm not
to put
playing
that,
Metal Gear after fucking 4.
I was hesitant to put that in my top 5.
I thought it was a weird addition.
It was an odd duck, and I know Metal Gear Solid is supposed to be generally an odd duck. I think even on those standards, Revengeance goes off whatever the fuck rail the series is on by the end. I mean, people tell me, Yatsu, what a fool! He said a Metal Gear game was too silly. And I'm like, yeah. And this is coming from someone who's played a lot of Metal Gear Solid games, and I understand that the series part of its charm is that it's a bit silly.
It has a wacky.
But even that goes a little bit too far with the end of Metal Gear Rising Revengeance. I'm sorry, that was what I felt.
Well, wasn't it a robot kid breakdancing cow machines to death or
something?
That's
the starting point.
Yeah, that's fine. There and it gets more sensible.
That's fine. The cyborg ninja flip-outs, that's the good shit. That's what made it fun for me. But by the end, it's just come on now. Come on.
Come on.
Come on. This is just... It started off goofy, now it's just absurd.
I think that can sum up Kojima just perfectly. It's just, come on.
just come on. Depictions of female characters, come on.
I know,
just come on, you can do better. I feel like a primary school teacher.
You can do better.
You can do better, boys. You can do better than pushing each other into the girls' toilets. You're better than that.
I don't think it's fair to use Kojima as a, an ambassador for all masculinity.
I dread to think who is, considering Kojima the bastion of humanity.
Nobody is an ambassador for the whole gender, because that's fucking asinine, and it reduces the individuality of each of us. You don't deserve to have your mistakes weighed against the entirety of your gender. It's ridiculous.
But even so, that's no reason not to call someone out for being kind of weird about
it. Oh, no, fuck no. Kojima's a nutbar.
I mean, all that business with the female character in Metal Gear Solid 5, who is apparently a mute and has her tits out all the time.
Silent nipples.
Yeah, pretty
much. I mean, honestly, and that's such a... It's like... You know, I used to think the whole having, loads of sort of sex, meaningless sex with people was great until I started actually having sex. And then it's like, you know what's good? Having sex with people you can fucking talk to and laugh with and be comfortable with. It makes it more pleasant by miles. I don't want to fuck randoms anymore. Good fucking God, no. It's horrible.
That guy who does the sexy tag must be a bit lacking in self-esteem.
Sexy.
He's put it fucking everywhere. He's like, no, really, I am.
How is the entire filthy public toilet supposed to know?
Well, if 3 filthy toilet doors didn't persuade you that I'm sexy, perhaps the 4th one will change your mind.
This guy seems pretty legit. All those public toilet stalls agree with him.
So, the other thing that happened this year was, of course, the new console generation. Yeah, you say that, but who's the one who's been playing Dead Rising 3 in the bar all the time?
Oh, yeah, in the bar. I mean, I've actively said that is in no way worth, like, what, $600 to get
one in again? And not buying drinks.
I'm sober, I don't drink.
Taking up space.
No, to be fair, I've told Cormac repeatedly that if he gets, like, some decent colas, like Jolt or maybe one of the Nuka colas, I'll buy those. It's just, you know, I'm not paying for a fucking Coke.
The idea is, Gabriel, that the games are free because the bar makes its money from selling drinks.
Well, given how much my tabs used to be when I worked there, I'd say I'm fairly reasonably covered.
Really?
Yeah.
That dog's so pissed at you for eating that meat. He was saving that.
that's my tire roast.
Hey, that's my tea. You bastard.
His creepy little mouth.
Hollywood cooked that specially for me.
Stabbing dudes. They have range, it's not fair. Knives.
Well, you've got a pile driver.
Fuck yeah. drivers and DDTs, those solve problems.
But
man.
Getting back to the new console generation, speaking of someone who had to get them, if you have to buy one or the other, I'd say the PS4 is your better option. But PC's better than all of them. But if you're so set in your ways, you gotta get a console, you big dude bro fat. Bastardy poo.
It's mate cunt in Australia. We don't have dude bros.
Poo of a head that you are. The PS4.
You ass clowns.
And mainly that's...
I probably shouldn't say ass clown either, because that's an Americanism.
And it might change if more exclusives come out, but for me, the first impressions is based on how long it takes between putting the disc in the drive and actually playing the bloody game on the disc.
I think the fact that you can turn the PS4 vertical is what puts it over the edge for me.
See, that's a relatively minor thing.
I know, and it's insane. God, look at the event horizon in the background.
Yes, did someone set off a nuke?
Yeah, probably.
Is this modern warfare all of a sudden?
Yeah, Hagar's the only one that will survive because he always did chest day.
Oh, look at that guy on that bench. He's got it figured out.
Yeah.
He's like, oh, hey, how you doing? Why must we fight, Mike Hagar? How about you just take a seat next to me and we'll watch whatever the fuck that is going on behind
okay,
the Statue
so it
of Liberty
wasn't a
there.
Nuclear bomb, it was the Statue of Liberty destroying Alderaan.
Is it having a piss? What's going on there?
Yeah, it's P destroying Alderaan.
And what's the Statue of Liberty doing here? I thought this was Mad City.
Mad City, New York. I think this is in the future after cloning's gotten out of hand.
Oh, I see, they renamed New York.
Yeah, why not?
They called it Mad City because this place is just mad.
Because the gang took over and now the mayor.
We're all a bunch of loonies, we. Now, don't think you can put a different head on Andre the Giant's body and think I won't notice final fight.
I love that he's called Abigail.
I think that might be the root of his aggression.
Boy named Sue. Giant muscle beast called Abigail.
Anyway, speaking of the new console generation... I read an interesting fact today which indicated that PS4 owners apparently have been watching more porn than Xbox One owners.
Well, the Xbox 360 didn't seem to have a native browser, so when I didn't have a laptop, I did all my porn watching on the PS3, so it might have something to do with that.
Spoken like a true expert in porn watching. So...
Hey, here's one for you, YouTube commenters. Draw Yahtzee as Andor, okay? Draw him in his Andor
costume.
Don't
do that. Don't listen to him. Draw me looking dignified.
Yeah, well, Yahtzee said not to do it. You know what that means.
Draw
internet.
Me in front of a bookcase. Sitting in a high back leather armchair and smoking a pipe.
Your dick getting sucked by a furry.
No. No. Wearing a Noel Coward style dressing gown and reading from a leather bound copy of the complete works of T.S. Eliot. And looking over my glasses as you enter and going, oh, excuse me, I didn't hear you come in.
I'm sorry, I didn't notice you there in this studio.
You know, that reminds me of a literary quote, but I can't think of one at the moment.
So, it didn't remind you of a literary quote? It reminded you of the concept of literary quotes?
Yes.
That reminds me of something I forgot.
Yes.
That reminds me of having strokes.
Anyway, let's have a fluffy topic. What's your New Year's resolution, Gabe?
I am going to learn to play the piano. Fuck you! Why is that a thing to laugh at?
I'm sorry, I just... You know when people... Excuse my merriment, but you know when people talk about having the hands of a concert pianist?
Yeah?
You do not have the hands of a concert pianist.
Well, I'm not gonna be a concert... I'm not trying to... See, this is the thing. I'm
you
not doing it...
You have the hands of someone who's stapled four Twixes to a to a burger patty.
Well, I do a lot of iron palm training, so there is that. But I'm not trying to be... See, this is the thing. I'm not doing it for, like... I'm doing it for me. It's a me thing. I want to be able to sit down at a piano and make music that I enjoy.
Why don't you learn to play the drums? That's the territory.
Because I'd need, like, a fucking drum kit, and those are expensive, and I...
Oh, and a piano isn't.
You can get, like, a fucking... Not a whole goddamn... You can get a keyboard for, like, you know, $100.
Oh, right. You want a Yamaha. You want to be the next John Shuttleworth.
I don't know who that is.
I'm going to have a private laugh at that you don't get.
Okay, you enjoy that. But no, I'm doing this, again, this is... It's one of those things where I actually did play as a kid when there was a school program for, kids on keyboards.
As a
kid.
And
then the school ran out of money, and I wasn't allowed to do that creative. So your learning opportunity gone because of fucking poverty school, that was...
Fucking Obama's America.
In Goodna, Australia. No, yes. See, I went to a primary school called Goodna in a suburb, funnily enough, called Goodna. And it's a toilet. It's
all
like,
right.
It is just a... Brisbane suburban ghettos, man. They're fucking beautiful.
You're always gone about that, but you lived in the city your whole life. Well, most of it.
The adult bit, yeah. Like, when I was able to not be there, it was fantastic.
I think that's just because you were looking at it through the eyes of a child who also hang around other feral children.
Yeah, there's. I was a feral. I didn't wear shoes for like 10 years.
Well, there you go.
Okay.
We assume of others what we know of ourselves. That's a favorite quote of mine.
That and, you know, I used to live there and it has serious problems.
Well, there you go. But anyway, yes, you played the piano when you were, what, 5 to 8?
Yeah, and I really enjoyed it. Like, I'm doing it as a personal enjoyment thing.
Did you have meaty big hands then? No, you did not.
Delicate little child fingers.
See, without wishing to blow my own trumpet, these are the hands of a concert pianist. They're thin and they've got a lot of reach and a lot of space between them.
They look like overcooked sausages with fingernails.
Ladies, I will finger you like a hydraulic device.
Yahtzee understands fucking women, female genitalia, Croshaw.
Seriously.
Hydraulic device. I will now turn the clitoris up to 800 PSI.
I meant my hand will be like a hydraulic device. It will be at, it will go at that shit like the T-1000. You'll be amazed. I'm just so very lonely.
I will attack the vulva. Yeah!
Yes.
Go on, get in up there!
Yes, I will hate fuck your clitoris with my fingernails.
Clitoris. You'll headbutt the thing is what you'll do. You'll pile drive it.
I will have the moistest forehead. Anyway.
Okay, I'm not getting the blame for that one, because that was a you one. That was all you, that wasn't me.
I'm using my angry energy that I have at the company that makes the H4N audio recorder.
You're gonna healthily direct some rage at a woman's genitals. Yeah, check, is it recording?
Yep, still recording. We're only on 40 minutes, actually.
That's because I've been racing through this with vicious ferocity, because I'm tired
of
seeing it.
It just seemed like longer.
Chest day!
Anyway, New Year's resolutions.
Yeah, so I'm going to learn the piano, and it's a personal thing. Like,
okay.
It's not a... I'm
it's not
do
to
it.
Say you wouldn't use it to show off given the opportunity, right?
Yeah. Well, you can do that. That's fine. But it's a difference
imagine you. I can imagine you being like the douche who brings his guitar to a party.
Oh,
except
fuck
you've got
no.
your Yamaha slung
around your neck. No. That person's a wang. It's like... I hate those things that people, like, little fucking accoutrements people put on themselves in lieu of having a personality. Like, in the early 2000s, it was fire twirling. Every fucking third boring prick was like, oh, I do fire twirling. And here's the thing about fire twirling. It's really interesting when you're really fucking good at it. But none of these people, and I feel sorry for the actual fire twirlers, because these posers are just fucking ruining it for them. And
right.
There were so fucking many. Every third prick had poise. None of them could do it well, because they were doing it just to have one thing to say about themselves.
I tried to teach myself pen twirling once. Well, just because I'm a massive fidgeter.
Yeah, so am I. So that's a thing that you can do.
Fidget so hard.
I'm a massive...
With your lady parts. But I tried to teach myself pen twirling just so I could fidget in an impressive way. That's also why I learned how to solve Rubik's cubes.
Yeah, well, I mean, that's...
My hands can solve Rubik's cubes. Think of what I could...
Rubik's pubes, Croshaw.
Think of what I could do to your puzzle, cunt.
You know, I'm actually kind of glad you went on that. I'm not going to call it a tirade. I don't really know how to describe that. But I'm glad you did, because that's just going to take the heat off of me. Because that was me talking about my sex life there for a while. For some reason, that seems to bother some people.
That's usually why I keep you around, because you say worse things.
Well, yeah, Gabriel Morton. I didn't say puzzle cunt this time. That'll be a chapter in my autobiography.
I think there are far worse things to say than puzzle cunt.
Mystery evolver.
Yes.
Automatic clitoris.
New Year's resolutions.
So what are you doing?
I don't really have one. You see, people make New Year's resolutions because they don't really have, you know, the discipline.
Yeah.
But I like to think I've never had a problem with discipline because I write novels.
Well, see, I was planning on doing the thing anyway. I mean, you know, you don't have a problem with self-discipline, which is actually quite impressive. I mean, you have to actually make yourself do work.
I get shit done.
Yeah.
Write a page a day and you'll never slow down.
There you go. There's your tip. There's your tip, fanfic writers.
I hear from a lot of people who say, oh, I got 30 pages into something. I've heard a lot from people who just love talking about the novels they've started. I don't hear from many people who finish them.
Well, that's the thing. Talking, and it's you know, the big problem with, like, quote-unquote activism these days is talking about a thing isn't doing it, but it makes you feel like you've done something.
Yeah.
People, and it just switches you off. It's really fucking bad.
People say, yeah, I got 3 chapters in and I'm just having trouble with it. And I'm like, yeah, that is the hump. That's what we call the hump. It's not pleasant. We all have to get past it. You are probably going to... You're not going to be excited by your book when it's done. At the end of it, you're probably going to be sick of it.
The fucking thing,
Usually by the time I record my audiobook, I do so with a sense of being completely sick of the entire text. Because I've gone through it so many times in writing and editing.
Like me at the start of round 2 of this fucking drownout.
But, you know, that's something we all have to do if we want to achieve things.
It's the fucking work. Not everything's a fucking cakewalk through the T-Park fun, like
playing through Final Fight, for example.
Twice in the same amount of hours.
Yeah.
Well, it's like fucking training. Like, it's repetitive. It is really fucking repetitive. And you can't skip the boring shit, because that's the basis of it.
Fuck you, man. You just do the same thing 10 times and then 4 more times. I have to be creative. Yeah. I have to come up with a new thing. It will be like you coming up with a different exercise 10 times in a minute.
Yahtzee Croshaw slaving over a hot dick jerk.
Yeah, you don't want it to be a cold dick joke. That will slap against the flesh like a cold piece of spam.
I'll just throw some Tabasco on that dick joke. That
is
right up.
That is a artificial heat. that was the exact wording of a routine we had in the previous take.
Yeah.
Hope you enjoyed it.
Nah. Learn to check the fucking recorder.
And then when Hagar threw the man out of his wheelchair, we went on a bit of an Obamacare tangent.
Well, because I suplexed a dude out of the wheelchair onto the wheelchair. It was much more impressive the first time
around.
Yeah,
fuck you.
And we were like the mayor, and it was kind of like death panels.
Fuck you, those requiring healthcare. I'm the mayor.
The thing I love about it so much is
the trickle-down theory helps those who help themselves. Yeah.
The thing I love about it so much is they think, like, there are people who think that their version of how they do it's the normal, sustainable one. And it's just the whole rest of the world does something different and you're the freaks and you don't seem to recognize that.
Do you think,
like, even right-wing people in this country would think twice about getting rid of fucking universal healthcare? Like, it's not a sensible thing. It's not...
Do you think the guy who has to keep relighting that stick of dynamite is really pissed off with you at this point?
I'd wager so. Ow!
He's like, fucking for God's sake, who
spinning
keeps...
Spinning lariat.
Who keeps...
Pile drivers.
Who keeps dropping these knives? This fuse wire isn't cheap.
This is an expensive kind. God damn, fuck...
And it's me who has to stencil.
Oh,
it's me who has to stencil the word dynamite along the tube as
That's
well.
That's really hard. Drop kick a motherfucker out a window. That's democracy, motherfucker.
Hey, who are these jokers?
They're the people I couldn't be bothered playing as because they can't jumping pile driver. And literally having like another move is Hagar's whole thing in this game.
Oh, thank you, Freddie Mercury. I was so scared.
That was my joke the first time around.
I know.
Lazy
I
cunt.
Nicked it.
Look at him. He does like. Ultra Freddie Mercury.
I like how he's got one eye open.
He's staring straight ahead.
I do not have feelings. I am too powerful. I sacrifice my feelings for muscle.
Yeah. All he can hear is the dull, raging hum of testosterone. Speaking of which, here are some bubbling crockpots of it.
Where are these guys going?
You know, to chill. They didn't do anything, but they're kind of tired anyway. And what my favorite part is, like, basically, like, Cody, the one on the left, like, Jessica is his girlfriend, and now he's just sort of walking away because the whole thing's been just too emotionally draining for him.
Oh, bless.
What a goddamn pussy.
He didn't even take a single punch. He let her dad do all the work. How pathetic is that?
Yeah. Well, my dad did all the work, but I can't have sex with him, so...
Excuse me, sir. My girlfriend's been kidnapped. I know traditionally this is my responsibility.
Okay, yeah, this is great. Cody! And then Cody won't turn around, so Guy beats him up.
What?
Go just, talk to your girlfriend.
Yeah, that's just how they communicate in
this
Rat
is,
City.
Yeah, you have to understand this is how very masculine individuals solve problems.
Yeah, all those guys you're beating up, they weren't even in the gang. They were just asking you for change. That's just how they do it around here.
That, I was playing, it was either Resident Evil 4 or 5, and I'd been playing it all fucking day. And then, like, a vagrant that had kind of, like, crazy face going on has just
Oh,
lurched.
Listen to this twat.
But I can't.
Not while evil still stalks
the streets.
You're not fucking Batman. Stop pretending
Cody.
To be Batman.
You're not even wearing a mask. You're just Guy.
You just have a weird...
Dude, man.
You just have a weird face. No, he's not Guy. The other guy's Guy.
Oh, yeah. I forgot that there was Guy.
That reminds me of the story of how they named Guybrush Threepwood.
Oh,
game over. And, to a lesser extent, game over again. But anyway, yes.
How did they name Guybrush Threepwood?
Well, the thing is, they made all the arse in Deluxe Paint.
All right.
And on the Amiga. And the Deluxe Paint file extension is .brush.
Ah.
So when they saved the file for the main character, he didn't have a name at that point. So they just gave him the generic name Guy. So Guy.brush.
Guy.brush.
And it just kind of stuck.
Yeah. What a neat little story.
Hmm. Makes you wonder what would have happened if that one artist had saved the file with a different
Dude.
Generic name.
Fella. Why are people called Guy but not Fella? Or Buddy? I suppose there is Buddy. Fella. Name one of your kids Fella.
Or Man.
Man.
So we'd end up playing a game with a character called Manbrush Threepwood. Hello. Hello. I'm Manbrush.
A fighting game starring Dude, Fella, and Guy.
I'm picturing that as an alternative name for Mike Hagar, actually. My name's Manbrush. Would you like a feel of it?
I'm noted gay-for-pay porn star Guybrush Meatwood.
Ah, I just got a text message from that speed dating service I used like a year ago.
I love how you use that and then, like, pick on me for not getting laid.
Well, it didn't fucking go anywhere.
Oh, yes, the girl delivery system that you use is somewhat ineffectual, is it?
It's not a girl delivery system. It's a mutual man and girl delivery system to being delivered
Do
to
Do they
both
know
genders.
You're the puzzle cunt master? Have you even put that up there?
Actually, the women stay put and the men move around, so it's a boy delivery system, if anything.
it's a boy pneumatic penis delivery
tube. It's a boy production line. It's a boy conveyor belt is what it is.
That's really how they should advertise that.
I've done a few turns on the boy conveyor belt.
I don't know. See, I can't do, like, digital dating things because I couldn't take it seriously, and I'd be kind of terrified to see what girls would respond to the kind of jokes that I'd put up there.
Hey, why don't you show us the intro for this game, since we missed it in this take?
That's probably why didn't go as long.
I love the look on Cody's face on this game. It's like someone across the way has just said something really offensive. And he's like...
I believe he just dropped his ice cream.
I cannot believe you'd have the audacity. What happened to the intro?
Well, because there are credits in it, it won't go to the attract mode, and the intro is attract mode.
Oh, well, never mind then.
Look, this is interesting. Well, what were you saying before we decided to do this? Because there was an actual conversation.
I can't remember. Something about puzzle cunts and New Year's resolutions.
Well, yeah, you're on the fucking penis delivery system. That's right, people. Like, if you're in the girls, if you're in the Brisbane area... Yahtzee, penis delivery system, make it happen.
Yeah, call our 24-hour toll-free number.
24-hour Yahtzee, just 1-800-YAHTZEE-COCK.
I may charge you taxi fare.
That's pretty cheap, girls. That's pretty fucking cheap, considering he's mastered the puzzle, cunt.
Well, to get back to New Year's resolutions, I guess I resolved to actually try to make some money out of indie game development this year.
Yeah. So what are you going to do with, like, the consuming shadow?
I'm gonna have a try with it. I'm thinking of putting, like, a Steam Greenlight page together and see what happens.
Yeah. Well, there you go, people. That thing you were playing for free now costs money.
Well, not...
Please support Yahtzee.
Well, not yet.
He's hungry.
I mean, I have put enough work into it that I feel I need to justify the time I've used on it.
You are... Yeah, it is becoming a bit of a time sink. I think you should sell advertising space for it.
Well, I did hear a story... pretend you haven't heard this one in the first take.
Okay.
I did hear a story about a guy who went to Kickstarter who made free, like, text adventure games that people seem to like.
Really? And he said, I have not heard that.
Yes, indeed. And he said, I quite like making these free text adventures, but I could need to pay my bills, so if I'll continue releasing free text adventures if you pay my bills. And they did.
That seems reasonable. That's what was it, patron?
Yeah, that's less buying a product and more being a patron of the arts.
Because producing this stuff is fucking work, and having to actually maintain your life outside of it is a fucking irritance.
Yeah, and that's like, unlike other Kickstarter properties, no one can feel they have like a sense of artistic ownership over it. You're just trusting the artist to do what appeals to them.
And the thing is, the bills will be a set amount, I presume. They're not like, oh, my bills are $1 million.
Well, it depends on how many steak dinners he wants, I suppose.
But I mean, you know, I for instance, live on like $597 a fortnight. Like, I live very fucking cheap.
Oh, look at you, Grizzly Adams.
Yeah.
I'm gonna keep coming up with new ones to these.
I hunt the homeless for money.
In terms of, look at you, X.
X.
Oh, look at you, Mr. Charity Case. Over here.
I don't know. Nicknames have never really stuck with me.
Oh, look at you, Mr. Nonce Whisperer. You know, I think I figured that out. Going back over the Quake 2 video where I called you the Nonce Whisperer because you said you'd predicted someone to be a pedo.
Yeah.
I think what it is, that was a case of stopped clock being right twice a day, you know?
Yeah, no, I know.
If you think everyone who looks weird is a pedo, of course you're going to be right once or twice.
No, well, that's the joke. And that's the sad thing about, like, things too, is, like, not every fucking pedophile looks like Dennis Ferguson, who admittedly looks like ultra-pedophile.
Because, of course, there are a lot of female pedophiles.
Well, just, again, it's not... It's, you know, the day you wake up and decide to fuck a kid, you don't get a big mark on your forehead, like, unfortunately.
Well,
no. Like,
well, I guess there is a certain amount of social maladjustment required that tends to come with looking weird.
Hey, that dude in that band that was... I can't remember the name of the band because I don't care about music, but he was like an ultra-fucking pedophile.
I suppose.
And he looks like a fucking handsome dude in a goddamn band. Like,
but it isn't helpful to group all forms of looking weird with each other.
No, well, that was, you know, that's the fucking point. It's a silly, you know, funny little thing to do. That was the joke about, like, being able to pick a pedophile. You kind of can't, unless you walk in and they're fucking a kid.
Guy's approach to the dynamite situation is a lot less manly than Hagar's approach, I think. He looked like a scared little girl.
Which is weird, because, like, in later games, Capcom make Guy, like, a complete stoic badass.
Well, he was the guy who punched the shit out of his friend for not talking to his girlfriend.
How men solve problems.
And, you know, the vibe I got from that is Guy has a lot of unfulfilled, frustrated sexual longing for the girl as well. And he was doing a thing like, go to her, you asshole!
Go to her, and do what I did, but gently into her vagina.
Okay.
What were we talking about?
I don't know. The use of the word vagina has derailed my train of thought.
Remember, ladies of Brisbane, you can make this happen. I really want this to happen now. I want someone in the YouTube comments to get on, like, whatever OkCupid you're on and, like...
No, I suppose I'd better clarify that was not serious.
Oh, here's... Okay, you could totally do a zero-punctuation-style review of Yahtzee's sex. Wouldn't that be something? You'd get a million hits on YouTube. That's stardom right there.
Well, don't expect a return call if you do that.
Wouldn't that be... That'd be something. I'd actually watch that.
But we were talking about making money for games.
Yeah.
I suppose I've always sort of shied away from that and released freeware games because as I said, you've always got that. Mm. If they don't like the game, you could say, well, worth the price of admission.
Yeah.
But if I'd known someone paid money for something they didn't like, I would just die.
But yeah, I mean, think about it though, like, think about what you could do if you actually were getting paid. Like, you'd be able to sink proper work time into it.
Yeah, I could make that Art of Theft sequel that I've been, like, tossing around for a while.
Some voice acting, sandwiches.
Well, the voice acting would all be me, putting on a variety of accents.
That would actually be kind of funny. Like, kind of Python-esque old ladies and shit.
Hello!
That sound... That I think it's Palin makes that sound.
Whoa,
like,
I just saw the other frame for Guy blowing on the candle, and he looked exactly like Robert Smith from The Cure. Except thinner.
Before he got fat, he looks like someone rolled a marshmallow through a goth store. I kind of like the goths, though. Like, goth chicks were cougars before it was cool. They really are. It's also impossible to age a goth because of the makeup.
I hate goths fucking invading the Roman Empire all over the place. Ha ha ha! Yeah. Your expectations were confounded and from thence the humor arose.
It's like a fucking clinic up in here. Take that, three identical bald guys.
I admire the dedication of whoever went through this subway car and broke every single window. That wasn't just random vandalism. That guy had a mission in life.
Just another poor soul with some really bad obsessive compulsive disorder.
Maybe that's like the starting like entry level gig for the Mad Gears.
I'm gonna try as like fucking Cody. It looks like one of those dogs that's been bred too much, like just...
How about next time we just let the dynamite explode?
Alright, this will be the last life.
Okay.
Cody, it's up to you. Save your girlfriend or she fucking dies.
Well, we've already saved them. This is just like the lap of honor, I suppose. Hey, spare some change for a grossly huge man. Ah!
I can't get a job because I don't fit in any subway.
For some reason, I imagine the sandwich shop there.
Yeah, that's what I was talking about. He can't fit in a subway. So that's why he doesn't have a job. He's in a subway now.
But yeah, he's in like a different kind of subway. That's what confused me.
Oh
my god, I just noticed. Andre the Giant has a wallet chain. What a twat.
Wallet chains are okay if you're going to a music festival. Otherwise, stop being a dick.
Yeah, or like somewhere else where there will be lots of people you don't trust.
Like if you get around on a skateboard and shit, because that was where it came from originally, if memory serves.
Like, or if you're, like, or if you're getting on a long plane flight, because what I find is that when you distribute the contents of your pockets around your seat pocket and your chair, things go missing quite easily. That's why they always tell you to check for your belongings when you get off.
Yeah, or that, and if you leave anything behind, it's terrorism and they'll fucking shoot your ass.
Yes. Because the TSA need to feel like they're getting shit done.
Have to look like they're doing something. And I suppose, yeah, you've actually dealt. Yeah, I've been to Japan, but I've, you know, never been to the States, so I haven't dealt with that.
Yes, you have never known my torment. That's right. That's the other thing we were talking about. How you've never really been in a really, really cold weather.
No.
Which comes from the fact that it's so fucking hot right now.
40 degrees, motherfucker. It was 40 degrees last I checked. That is not okay. That is not a fucking temperature humans are supposed to live at. Well, humans can live at that, but they tend to be, you know, brown and not big Norse things like myself.
As I was saying, I still prefer the being really hot to being really cold, because when you're really hot, at worst, you get sweaty and get little shit done.
Yeah.
When you're really cold, you start losing body parts.
Having never really experienced that or even seen snow, I'd trade... You know, right now.
Yeah, you've never been in the kind of cold where you have to walk to school in it and it penetrates every layer you try to put between you and it, and when you get to the school you can't even feel your toes.
I don't think I have that problem exactly if I was in that nation, given that I'm 30, but... Okay, that's Guy's thing that Cody's thing that he can do. He actually holds onto the knife.
You probably regard snowball fights as a sort of thing of idyllic charm, don't you?
I really do. It looks like fun.
You've spoken as a man who's never had one shoved down the back of his shirt.
No, see, in Goodna we used to do this thing called sand crack, where you'd basically sneak up on someone who was half bent over, grab a handful of sand, and just toss it down their pants. Yeah, and on a hot summer day, getting a big pile of fucking sand down into your butt, not fun.
Now, he looks like Aaron Eckhart.
He does too. He's about to become No Face.
Yeah, that works surprisingly well.
Bye-bye, Cody. Your girlfriend's gonna get...
You'll never get weirdly, creepily angry about the death of someone you didn't even know for that long.
Yeah. It's kind of weird, too, because what was the dude in the wheelchair actually planning to do to Jessica?
Well, apparently fuck all. I mean, he wasn't, like, holding her to ransom. He was
Razor
just, like,
as his own, maybe.
It was almost like... He was just contriving some reason for some people to go and have a big fight somewhere. Like some kind of badly written video game.
Ah, brawling game stories.
Well, we're about at an hour now.
Thank fucking Christ.
So, a happy new year to all our listeners. Sorry you missed the good one.
Are they listeners or are they viewers?
Well, I like to think most people... Maybe alt-tab over to something else that they're reading or working on, and just listen to our delightful conversations.
There's one person who mutes us and just watches the gameplay who's going to go on a complete tirade in the comments now. I look forward to that.
Well, there's plenty of people who just put up video footage. But
see, I like that because that's museum stuff.
And there's a lot of things, there's a lot of like YouTube videos I'll just put on and just to listen to while I work. Yeah. I do that with some Retsupre videos I've watched often enough that I...
Retsupre.
I just find their voices comforting.
See, I quite like the ones that are just, here's the game. Because that's kind of like Wikipedia for gameplay mechanics, because you can't read about gameplay mechanics, you kind of got to see it in action.
Well, we played all the way to the end of this game, so it might technically be an actual let's play, rather than a let's drown out.
Well, we should, yeah, and we started again and gave you a look at the other characters for comparison.
Oh, but we did talk about other shit, though.
What do you think about the gameplay of Final Fight, Yahtzee?
It looks like several burly men punching several other burly men in the crotch.
Correct.
QED. Bye.
Yep.